The Voice in Speech and Song, Chapter 72, Song at Christ's Resurrection and Ascension. Heaven's Welcome to the Risen Lord. At the resurrection, they, the soldiers guarding Jesus' tomb, saw the brightness of the angels illuminate the night, and heard the inhabitants of heaven singing with great joy and triumph. Songs by the Angel Host. They, the soldiers guarding the tomb, see Jesus come forth from the grave and hear him proclaim over the rent sepulchre, "I am the resurrection and the life." As he comes forth in majesty and glory, the angel host bow low in adoration before the Redeemer and welcome him with songs of praise. Praise to Christ at his ascension. All heaven was waiting to welcome the Savior to the celestial courts. As he ascended, he led the way, and the multitude of captives set free at his resurrection followed. The heavenly host, with shouts and acclamations of praise and celestial song, attended the joyous train. As they drew near to the city of God, the challenge is given by the escorting angels, "Lift up your heads, O ye gates, and be ye lift up, ye everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in." Joyfully the waiting sentinels respond, "Who is this King of glory?" This they say, not because they know not who he is, but because they would hear the answer of exalted praise, "The Lord strong and mighty, the Lord mighty in battle." "Lift up your heads, O ye gates, even lift them up, ye everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in." Again is heard the challenge, "Who is this King of glory?" For the angels never weary of hearing his name exalted. The escorting angels make reply, "The Lord of hosts, he is the King of glory." Then the portals of the city of God are opened wide, and the angelic throng sweep through the gates amid a burst of rapturous music. He presents to God the wave sheaf, those raised with him as representatives of that great multitude who shall come forth from the grave at his second coming. He approaches the Father, with whom there is joy over one sinner that repents, who rejoices over one with singing. With joy unutterable, rulers and principalities and powers acknowledge the supremacy of the Prince of Life. The angel host prostrate themselves before him, while the glad shout fills all the courts of heaven, "Worthy is the Lamb that was slain to receive power and riches and wisdom and strength and honor and glory and blessing." Songs of triumph mingle with the music from angel harps, till heaven seems to overflow with joy and praise. Love has conquered. The lost is found. Heaven rings with voices in lofty strains proclaiming, "Blessing and honor and glory and power be unto him that sitteth upon the throne and unto the Lamb forever and ever."